Hey guys, welcome back to the channel.
Are you guys looking for an anime where our MC is an underestimated transfer student who's actually overpowered and badass? Well, you came to the right place, since that's what we will be covering today. So take a seat, grab some snacks, and I hope you guys find a new anime to binge watch. Oh, and make sure to leave a like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already to help us reach that 50,000 subs goal. Number 10. Food Wars, Shokugeki no Souma. Ever since he was little, Souma Yukihira's main goals have been to beat his father in a cooking contest and take over the family diner. That's why when his dad suddenly announces that he's shutting the restaurant down and sending Souma to cooking school, Souma is shocked. However, Totsuki Academy is no ordinary cooking school. This elite institution is filled with culinary giants, like Arina Gautung Nakiri, who does her best to keep a lowly short order like Souma from even making it inside the door. However, if the snobs can dish it out, Souma can serve it up. And when he learns that only a handful of the students manage to graduate every year, he swears that the only way he'll leave is as number one. Number 9. Aria, the Scarlet Ammo. Tokyo is on edge due to a rash of recent killings targeting Butei, armed mercenaries that perform odd jobs and capture criminals. So when Kinji, a student at a local Butei high school, hits the class one day and discovers a bomb has been rigged to his bike, he's certain he'll be the next victim. That is, until Kinji's elite classmate Aria saves his life, inadvertently triggering his superhuman ability that flares when he's sexually aroused. Though Kinji would rather slack off at school and be left alone, Aria is now determined to make the teenager her slave, fetching her food and partnering with her on missions, including one very important to the girl. And nothing will stand in her way, not even Kinji's possessive childhood friend. Number 8. Riddle Story of Devil. Tokaku Azuma has just transferred to the elite Myojo Academy, a private girls' boarding school. But there's a catch. She, along with 11 of her fellow students in Class Black, is an assassin taking part in the challenge to kill their sweet nature classmate, Haru Ichinose. Whoever succeeds will be granted their deepest desire, no matter the difficulty or cost. However, each assassin only gets one chance. If they fail to kill her, they will be expelled. Despite the extraordinary reward, Tokaku decides to take a different course of action. Though Haru is her target, the young assassin soon finds herself drawn to the very girl she is supposed to kill. With the entire class out for Haru, Tokaku refuses to let her friend die, vowing to protect her from a growing bloodlust. Number 7. Blue Exorcist. Humans and demons are two sides of the same coin, as are Asiya and Gehenna, their respective worlds. The only way to travel between the realms is by the means of possession, like in ghost stories. However, Satan, the ruler of Gehenna, cannot find a suitable host to possess, and therefore remains imprisoned in his world. In a desperate attempt to conquer Asiya, he sends his son instead, intending for him to eventually grow into a vessel capable of possession by the Demon King. Ren Okumura, who appears to be an ordinary, somewhat troublesome teenager. That is, until one day, he is ambushed by demons. His world turns upside down when he discovers that he is in fact the very son of Satan, and that his demon father wishes for him to return so they can conquer Asiya together. Not wanting to join the King of Gehenna, Rin decides to begin training to become an exorcist, so that he can fight to defend Asiya along his brother Yukio. Number 6. Dragonar Academy. Learning to ride and tame dragons comes easy to most students at Ansarivan Dragonar Academy, except for first year student Ash Blake, who is known by his fellow classmates as the number one problem child. Poor Ash is a laughingstock at school because, Despite his unfashionably large star-shaped brand that marks him as a future dragon master, he has nothing to show for it. His dragon has never appeared. Until now, that is. One fateful day, Ash's dragon awakes in full glory, but appears different than any dragon ever seen before, in the form of a beautiful girl. Number 5. Unbreakable Machine-Doll. After miserably failing the Academy's entrance exams, Raishin Akabane and his humanoid automaton Yaya must defeat one of the top 100 students to earn the right to take part in the evening party, a fight for supremacy between puppeteers using their automatons. The last one standing is bestowed the title of Wise Man, and granted access to the powerful forbidden arts. Thus, Raishin challenges Charlotte Bilou and her automaton Sigmund to a duel. But before they even begin, Sigmund is attacked by other students. After saving his opponents from their assaults, Raishin cancels the duel, but is forced to search for a new way to gain access to the party. Driven by the tragedies of his past, Raishin fights alongside Yaya to rise to the top and claim the title of Wise Man. Number 4. Nanana's Buried Treasure. Disowned by his father, Jugo Yama has run away from home to the island of Nane. He begins to live by himself, only to discover his room is haunted by the ghost of Nanana Ryugajo. She was murdered 10 years ago, and her killer must be found before she can rest in peace. Before her death, Nanana collected things from all over the world and hid them throughout the island. Using the mysterious powers of these hidden items, they should be able to find the culprit. As Jugo begins his hunt for the collection, however, he discovers he's not the only person searching. Number 3. Kill la Kill. Ryuko Matoi is a fiery, feisty girl on a vengeful mission. She'll find her father's murderer at all costs, with only a giant red scissor blade as a clue to the villain's whereabouts. Using the item as a weapon, she fights her way into the terrifying Honnoji Academy to track down a lead, unaware that the Institute is brutally governed by a student council that's anything but ordinary. Wielding special Goku uniforms, the group, led by President Satsuki, uses superpowers to keep the student body in check. But things are about to change now that Ryuko's in town. Number 2. 100. 100. The only weapon capable of fighting the savages, mysterious life forms attacking Earth. Hayato enters the Battleship University Little Garden in hopes of becoming a slayer. But his roommate, Emil Crossfode, who seems to know a lot about him for some reason, awakens a sort of unsettling nostalgia within him. What's more, right after he joins the school, the strongest slayer at Little Garden, the Queen Claire Harvey, challenges him to a duel. Number 1. Tokyo Ravens. As a descendant of the famous Tsuchimikado Shaman Clan, Harutora is a failure. He has no talent, can't grasp magical theory, and he can't even see spirits. Thankfully, his cousin Natsume is the heir to the family line instead. But unfortunately for the girl, it puts her in the crosshairs of other shamans who hold grudges against their clan or seek to exploit her power for their own. To help keep her safe from the dangerous world of the supernatural, Harutora decides to become Natsume's familiar and protector. So together, they learn about magical techniques, banishing spirits, and fighting together as a team, while doing their best to keep Natsume out of harm's way. Let me know your thoughts down in today's video in the comments below. And if you're new here and haven't joined our awesome community, then you're missing out. So please give the video a like and hit that subscribe button to help our channel grow and reach our 50,000 subscriber goal. I take topic recommendations, so feel free to drop yours below, and I will do my best to make a video out of it if I really like it. With that being said, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace!